Greetings and welcome to Jefficho Films. Harry Potter and Samara Weaving in a 2019 action movie? Sign me up. So let's review Guns Akimbo.
7 million viewers and counting. You're the most watched schism contestant ever.
That many people are watching me?
I've never seen anything like it. Hey, can I get a selfie?
Yeah, sure.
This movie starts out with an evil computer down talking us, telling us that schism is the virus. And then we see Nyx driving a sweet car being shot at by a truck, and then she takes them all out, and all this is being filmed and watched online. Miles tells us his life is sad, his job is to flag offensive material online, and his boss is a bit of a dick, but he's got a pretty sweet home. We learn that Schism picks weirdo psychos and makes them fight to the death. Miles goes home, has a couple of beers, and watches a video, and is upset by the comments. This is what he generally flags, so he decides to become a troll hunter that night. He starts insulting this guy who can track him. Then he gets a text from his ex-girlfriend, and she wants to meet up at the park. And so he goes, and he makes up with her, but it's a dream.
He's a man who is bitten by a radioactive man, and he gets superhuman powers of manliness.
I mean, no.
My man sense is tingling.
Then four people break into his house and start threatening him, and then they trank him, and he wakes up to them doing some odd surgery on him. Then he wakes up in his bed, safe and sound, but he's got two guns attached to his hands, surgically attached with no way to remove them. Then he gets a text that his opponent is Nyx, and he has 24 hours to kill her or he dies. And we see Nyx just fucking up a ton of people. She has a deal with him, one more kill, and she's out. I love Samara Weaving, this is one of the reasons, because she does these hyperviolet movies. She goes undercover at the police station to find Miles, and she's amazed when he has no criminal record, but she does find his place and he tries to reason with her, but then she starts shooting at him, so he has to run off. The cops chase him because he runs up and asks for help, but he's got guns attached to his hands, so that doesn't work out. He eventually gets tased and accidentally fires the gun off and shoots a cop in the shoulder, and then he runs and sees his ex-girlfriend and jumps in her car. She freaks when he tries to explain what's happening, and she runs off, and then he has to crawl out of her car. It's a good thing her window just keeps going magically up and down so he can do that. He hides out for a bit and then tries to get clothes on and gets depressed, and then he runs into the Jumanji guy, but I know him from Flight of the Conchords.
Why shouldn't I?
Well, the angle's all wrong. You won't hit your brain. You'll just end up blowing your damn face off.
Oh. Okay, thanks.
And then you'll still be depressed. Even more depressed, probably, because of your fucked up face.
Noah and his ex goes to the cops to try and help him, but they don't seem to care. They just want to use him for bait. And Glenjamin, the bum, decides to help them dress him. Miles goes to work, but he should go to the hospital and get those guns removed. He gets his work buddy to turn off the malware that's tracking him, and then his boss goes there and just starts bitching him out so he stands up to him. But then Nyx shows up and ends up shooting the boss, but his work buddy does cover his attempted escape.
I need to get out of here! You're covered! Fucking cover! You, wait, what am I gonna do? Camp her ass in the staple gun?
Mistakes were made.
He manages to get into a car, but driving with two guns is not easy. And then Nyx chases him on a bike, and the big car accident happens, and he runs off again. And she starts explaining to him how his guns work.
Alright, I'm just saying this because I'm honestly so fucking embarrassed for you. Relax your damn arms. Elbows slightly bent, nearly straight.
Shut up!
And those two little sight things on the barrel aren't just for decoration.
We learn that Schism will wipe her record clear after she kills him. We also learn that she has some trauma. Back when she was a kid, big car crash and a fire. So whenever she sees fire, she freaks. Miles calls Nova and explains, and this time, she listens. But then some Schism guys show up and kidnap her and his work buddy and tell him that he has to stop running. He reactivates his phone tracker, and then he calls 911 and leaves it in his car at the junkyard. And then he accidentally wanders into a drug deal, and they're gonna shoot him, but then Nyx shows up with a Gatling gun and heart-shaped sunglasses. Oh, Samara. The cops show up and Miles is on the run, but he does manage to get his first kill before getting arrested. And the two detectives say that they are going to use him for bait. And then the one crazy detective is all like, oh, my family was killed by Riktor, the head of Schism. And he managed to save his daughter, Nyx. But then this happens.
Hey, Stan, where the fuck are we?
Whoa! Holy shit, dude! What the actual fuck? Is that look supposed to fucking explain something?
Riktor owns the cops, and Miles decides to go to this gaming place and get them to track his ex-girlfriend's phone's location so that he can get there and save her. But when he does, Riktor kills his best friend from work. So he reactivates his phone and meets up with Nyx and has a friendly little chat.
Team up! I got a much better chance if I'm with you, I know that. So, you in?
Yeah.
No.
Maybe not a friendly chat, and then Riktor orders Nyx killed, and a cleanup crew comes to pick up Miles' body, and they throw it in a body bag and drive it back to headquarters, where he shoots out of the body bag and kills them both. And then he meets up with Nyx, who's in on it. And then we get a flash of Miles explaining to her that Richter's the one that had her family killed and put her in a game so that she wouldn't come after Riktor. And then she sees her dad dead, and that's how she got the vest and put it on him.
Look, if you're not gonna shoot yourself or me, then I have a plan. It is kind of fucked up and totally suicidal, but it might work. You get to kill Riktor, I find Nova, but we have to work together.
Next, they break into Schism's headquarters and start shooting everybody. Miles is almost out of bullets, and Nyx just keeps shooting everybody in the dick.
Really? Another dick shot? Oh, God! Damn it, please, why do you have to keep doing that?
What? I would have shot you in the dick if the target wasn't so small.
Miles manages to get on one of their computers and see that Schism's gone worldwide before some of the side bosses show up. Nyx has a hand to hammer combat, and some of the lines are pretty good, but some of them take you out of it. Some of the jokes are just a little too much. Miles and Nyx get pinned down, and then Nyx decides to go charging in and starts taking them out before suicide bombing in the end. Miles has one bullet left, and he has to find Nova, who's being taken to the roof by Riktor, and he gets there, and he fires his one shot, and he misses, and then he gets shot. Then he gets shot two more times. I think the vest should have protected him from that stomach one. He manages to throw Riktor off the roof, and then he imagines him and Nova making out, but really, he's just bleeding out. A little while later, and we see that Nova's been making comics about Miles and Nyx versus Schism, and then we see that they are worldwide, and Miles is hunting them. The end. I like this cast. Daniel Radcliffe is always solid. He's been searching for roles to set himself apart from Harry Potter, and he succeeded. He's been constantly, every time I see him in something, it's usually pretty good. Samara Weaving, how can you not love her? And these hyper-violent movies she keeps doing. I recommend Ready or Not, The Babysitter, and Mayhem if you're enjoying these. Natasha Lou Bordizzo was a pleasant surprise in this as his ex-girlfriend and motivation, and it also helped keep some of this movie grounded in this unrealistic hyper-violence. Ned Dennehy as Riktor, you know, he reminded me a lot of Ian Shame, but he kept pretty grounded in this, even though some of his lines were pretty bad. I also enjoyed seeing Rhys Darby as the bum, watching him trying to dress Miles and teach him things. It's a good addition of comedy.
For all you know, I could be a savant programmer who got screwed after my startup went bust.
I'm so sorry. Are you?
What? No! I spend all of my time getting fucked up on a bunch of crack.
Oh, good for you.
Want to smoke some crack?
In the end, this is one of those ultra-violent movies that actually has a message about us just being stuck to our cell phones and how we would actually watch people get killed and how negative news is more important than positive news to most people. Really takes a shot at society on that one, so props for that. I really enjoyed this. I thought it was a lot of fun. There were a few times where, you know, you're taken out of it because they just tried too hard with some of the comedy, but overall, it was a fun movie to watch, so I recommend you do. As always, thanks for watching.